something like a 10 or a 12 inch screen, like a Galaxy or a Zoom tablet. Here's the Dell Streak 7, 7 inch screen. It's got dual NVIDIA processors. If I'm not mistaken, it's got 2 gigabyte of RAM, 16 gigabyte of internal storage, and I've got a 16 gigabyte SD card external storage. Built in Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, GPS, accelerometers, G-sensors, forward and rear facing cameras with flash. Front camera is 0.3 megapixel. Kind of typical of a ordinary webcam. The back camera is 5 megapixel. It takes excellent video and pictures. But I just want to get into some of the basics. Usually when you, as you can see, my screen is full of apps. When you first get yours, if you get a new tablet, you'll see a lot of the same stuff on the screen at the top and the bottom, but you may not see so many apps. The first thing to realize with the Android is it'll come up to your default desktop screen, and you actually, I'm running Android 3.2, and first of all, realize that you have 5 desktops. And it comes up to the, by default, it comes up to the third desktop, the one in the middle. And we'll see how those are arranged in a second. But when you run out of space here, you can just grab the screen and just gently slide. There's my second desktop. Really have much on that one except a alarm clock. And instead of sliding, you can slide left and right, or you can just touch the side like that. There's my default desktop, number 4, number 5. Anyway, we'll go back to the default. Now, I'll start at the top and then work my way to the bottom and explain some of the icons. Most of all these icons will be the same from device to device, but the user interface itself may vary from device to device, but most of these symbols are going to be the same. This is pretty self-explanatory up here at the top left. This is a Google search that'll automatically let you search the instantly search the web. There's a microphone beside that. I can demonstrate that now. If I tap the microphone, it's going to do a Google search with the incredible voice recognition that's built into these devices. Very super accurate. So I'm just going to tap the microphone. Planet X. And there it goes. It's doing a search. And it understood me clearly. Okay, now you're saying, how do I get out of here? There's two ways to get out. Down here at the bottom left, you see a back arrow. You can either hit that, or on my device, I have 3 buttons to the side. There's a total of 5 buttons on this entire device. I got a power button right here. I'll draw it, actually. Right, let's see, where is my, buttons on this thing are touch sensitive over here. I'll draw them out. Right here is your back button. That would be the same as clicking or touching this button on your screen. Right here, this is a options or a menu button. If you're in an application and you want to get to the settings and options menu, usually that's the button you'll want to hit. And then right below that, again, a lot of these buttons will be on other devices, maybe in different places. Right here, the home button. That will just take you back to your home screen. Now, some apps will remain open and running in the background if you don't exit them and just hit your home button. So, for instance, I can go back home. And this will give me a chance to explain this button right here. It looks like several windows on top of each other. Sorry for my crude drawing. Anyway, that button right there. This will show you the apps that you've either recently run or that are running processes. And here are the most recent activities that I've done. Now, since I just went home and did not exit the browser, it should still be there. So all I have to do is bring up my recent activity or open processes, tap my browser, and it'll take me back to it. If the application has exited, it'll just take you back to where you were. Now I can get out of this two ways. I can hit this back arrow that's on the screen, or I can use the hardware button. I'll just use the hardware button. Go back. Go back again. And if at any time you find that you are not going back to your desktop, you can always hit home. Okay, how do you get things on your desktop? Well, first of all, let me show you how to navigate and move icons around. Let me get to a screen that's not so cluttered. We've only got 5 applications on this, so this is a good demonstration. To grab an icon and move it around on your desktop space, you just touch it and hold. Usually you'll feel a vibration. And now you're free to move it, and it will lock in place. There's a grid pattern that you may not be able to see, but then I can drop it there. I can rearrange these wherever I want. A quick single tap will launch it. Say you want to get an item off of your desktop. It won't. Now this will not delete your app, but if you want to get the icon off of your desktop, you grab it. You drag it over to the trash can until it turns red, and then you let go, and that icon will be removed. I would like to keep that one, so put it back where it was. You know what widgets are. There's two ways, or two easy ways, that you can add a widget, or an app, or a MIDI application to your desktop. Anywhere where you have blank space, you can tap and hold your screen. Now what you'll see up here at the top, you want to outline it. These are your 5 desktops. That's the one I was just on. Over to the right, I got 3 that are pretty filled up, and then I got my number 1 desktop, which only has a clock. Below that is a list of widgets. there a different way. Almost all the devices will also have this plus sign at the top, left or right. To manage your desktop, we've seen before how you can touch the screen and hold, and there you go. There's your five desktops, and you have your widgets, applications, still and animated wallpapers. The animated ones are called live wallpapers, and then you've got additional things that you can add. Let me go back home, hit the home button. There's another way you can get there. This plus button means you want to add something to your desktop. So there we go. Two ways to do it. Let's look at some of the widgets. Let's see, I got AccuWeather, Amazon, okay. Well, no, I don't care about Amazon MP3 player. Again, all you gotta do is go down here and slide. Battery monitors. Let's see, what do we got? Okay, here's a calendar. I want this calendar, let's say, over here with my clock. All I gotta do, grab this, drag, drop. Now, I can go immediately to any of these desktops by touching them. So let's go to that one, where we just drop the clock. Give it a tap, and there you are. Sometimes you can resize these apps. As shown before, you can move it to a different part of the screen by grabbing onto it, touch it, hold, move it, and drop it where you want. And you'll notice when I let go, I've got 4 points. I can grab one of these points and resize this window to any size I want. Stretch it to the left. That may be the maximum size. No, I can go up. There we go. See if I can go any more. Sure can. So, I've increased the size of my widget. That's how you do it. You hold down and let go, and then you'll have your anchors where you can resize your widget. Click anywhere or touch anywhere. You've got to quit using the term click, and that goes away. Now, if I want to configure the options within my calendar, there's a setting button way up here. If I tap it, it'll just launch it. I have no event, so there's nothing to launch. This will take me into my settings for my calendar. Actually, I've never used this little widget, so I just wanted to demonstrate on how to put one on the desktop. I'll go back. There we go. I can schedule reminders and appointments and notifications, and you can tell it what time to notify you, things like that. Let me go back. Alright, I'm not going to use this, so I'm going to remove this. Now, this does not delete the app. Grab it. Let's get this off my desktop. Remove. Turns red. Let go. How do you change your wallpaper? Well, we can either hit the plus button to get back to our desktop customization. I like just touching the screen because it's easier. Let's get the wallpapers. You can go to your photo gallery of your own. wallpaper that comes on the unit. I tend to like the animated wallpapers, although they do take up a little bit of CPU time. And here's just some that I tend to like this 3D hyperspace, and a lot of these are free in the Android market. You just pick the one you want, scroll through the list, see what you got. There's a frequency analyzer that'll it'll be your background wallpaper, but it'll be like an audio spectrum analyzer. There's all sorts that come with the devices, and there's a ton more for download. Let's go to 3D Hyperspace. It'll give you a preview, give you a chance to adjust your settings, and change orientation, which is okay. No thank you. Anyway, if I hit set wallpaper, choose another one. This wants me to buy something. Oh, it did set it. Go back home. I'm gonna pick a different one. Again, hold your screen. Wallpapers. Live wallpapers. Let's try the aquarium. You can adjust your settings here. I'm going to go ahead and set wallpaper. I'm happy with how that looks. There you go. That is now your desktop wallpaper. Let's say I want to go back to my primary desktop. I just tap right here. And there we go. Virtual aquarium. But this does take up some CPU time, so if you have a slower device, you may want to stick with a static image. I'll change that back. Let's see. I can go to the gallery, but I'm just going to look through my stock wallpaper. Carbon fiber look. Let me choose that. And there, now it's set. Now there's two different ways you can add applications to your desktops. You can do it this method and just go to your apps. As I showed you before, when we added the compass over here to this desktop, you can do it right here, or you can do it this way. Let me go back to my home desktop. Go back. There we go. This button up here at the top that says apps. Now yours may or may not say apps, but it should have this. So I'm going to outline it. Cannot draw a very good purple. It'll look like six little boxes with one lit up. That is to get to your app list. It would kind of be the equivalent to your installed programs in Windows. So here's a list of all my apps. Quite a few. I've had this tablet a while. And I'll just see. Let me find one. I know I don't have on there. Okay, here's Facebook. If I want to add Facebook out of my app list, take the icon, select it, and hold it until you see your desktops appear. Okay. Now I can drag it to any one of these desktops that I want. I'll put it over here. And like that. itself, but it'll give you more details. If you want to get rid of the notification, bring it up, hit the X. Let's see, this is telling me we have a new moon. Let me get rid of that. Had a solar flare. Informative. This is telling me I have updates available. Battery charging. I think I accidentally clicked to go update this, and I'm not ready to do that, so let's back out. So anyway, your notifications are all on the bottom. Right here is your Wi-Fi strength. If it's grayed out, then your Wi-Fi has turned off. Sometimes it will turn itself off if you're low on battery. It should be blue if you have a connection, and that'll show your signal strength. Next to that, you have your battery status. If you want more properties about your clock, you can do this motion right here. You start with your finger on the time and just swipe up. And it'll give you a list of your recent notifications. It tells you what network you're connected to, your battery, has your mixer. And to get rid of that, you can either hit back or you can take your finger and swipe down. It's the exact opposite. That covers some of the basics, folks. Let me go back to my home desktop. I may do another video and go a little bit deeper, and we can get into the settings, which is, again, it may look a little different on your device, but it's basically all the same. And show you how to turn your device into a portable 3G or a 4G hotspot, tethering to use your connection to provide other devices with Wi-Fi internet, your Bluetooth devices, power management, sound, screen, all this various stuff right here. So maybe in the next video we will get into that. This is kind of for the new users, just to kind of get you up to date on the new technology and how to navigate your Android. Hope you found this helpful. Drop a comment. If you'd like to see something demonstrated in the future, just let me know. I'll be more than happy to do another little Android 1-on-1. Android 102.